Hello everyone, welcome back. In this video we'll be working on getting your server's bans with your bot and unbanning people. So first I'm going to demonstrate. If we use bans, it should pull up the list of bans that we have. Okay, we have one ban. Okay, and then we can unban. I can use ID. I can copy this ID and paste it here. And they've been unbanned. And if we go and check bans again, there are no bans. So now let's jump into the code. Okay, first we need to import a couple things. I'm gonna be using Pycord, and this should also be compatible with Discord PY. You may have to make some moderate adjustments. So first we're gonna need to import Discord, daytime, option, commands, and missing permissions. Okay, now let's define our bot as our Discord bot. And let's create a list of server IDs that we want our slash commands to be pushed out instantaneously in. If you're using global slash commands and this is a server all across the servers that your bot is in, you won't need to define this. Okay, I'm gonna create an event so whenever our bot comes online, it's gonna say we have logged in. Okay, now let's create our first slash command, bans. Okay, so we're gonna define our guild IDs as our list of servers, so the slash command we pushed out instantaneously. We're gonna call it bans, and our description is gonna be get a list of members who are banned on this server. So now let's actually work on the code. Oh, almost forgot. We need to add a permissions check to make sure that the author has banned members' permissions. Okay, first let's defer. So because it may take a while to get all the bans, it may take a while and we want to defer. So we don't want the Discord to say that we did not respond in time. So this will get a list of bans from the guild. Let's continue. Okay, so we're gonna create an embed really quickly. So basically, we're gonna use fields to add each ban, so it's a little neater, right? And we're gonna have our color as red, the timestamp as the current time. This timestamp doesn't really matter what your time zone is. Discord will adjust it to the user's time zone. So now let's continue. So basically what we're gonna do is we're gonna do a for, because this bans variable is a list. We want to go through the list and add fields. Okay, so I was editing the video that you were just watching and you are still watching, and I made a slight mistake, so I'm going to add a little bit of code to this. So essentially, what we're going to do is we're going to have a for, and we're going to check for entry and bans. So we're going to go through every single ban and name it entry. Okay, and we want to check something. We want to add an if function. If the number of the fields, embed fields, is greater than 25, we break. This is really important because the Discord limit for number of fields is a maximum of 25, and you don't want to exceed that. Okay, and then now we check if the number, the total characters of the embed is greater than 5,900. If it is, we're going to add a field. This assumes that this has not occurred, right? If none of these are called, then the bot will add a field to the embed called ban, and its value is going to contain the banned member's username, discriminator, and the reason for the ban, as well as the user ID and whether they're a bot or not. And then it's going to respond with the embed. Okay, so we create an input ID, which is a Discord member, which can be a 17 to 18 user ID, member ID, or snowflake, whatever you call it, and we're going to call our slash command unban and description unbans a member. So now let's continue, and the input for the ID is required. So now let's continue. Okay, so what's essentially going on here is that we do a permissions check to see if the user, the author, has band members' permissions. If they do, continue. Otherwise, it's going to raise an error. So we have an input ID, which is required, which is the user ID of the person, right? And then we defer, and then we define member as a get or fetch with the ID, and then we unban the member. And then we respond saying, I have unbanned the member and mentioned them. Okay, now let's work on error handling. Okay, so we have an event, so whenever there is an application command error or whenever a slash command has an error, we check if it's because of missing permissions. If it is, we're going to say you need band members' permissions to do this. Otherwise, we're going to respond saying something went wrong, I couldn't unban this member, or this member isn't banned. So this last part, this else, is really broad. Some possibilities are that the bot doesn't have permissions to ban, or the member is unbanned, or the bot just didn't have the permissions to do so, and it's going to raise the error. For public bots, I would customize the error handling a little bit to do checks and see what exactly the error is, and then respond with a response. Say if the bot is missing permissions, it's going to respond that the bot does not have sufficient permissions to unban this member, and we'll do it like that. But this part is really broad, since we don't really want to go into detail. We're just going to make it very broad, and we're just going to have a response and raise the error. Okay, so now let's test the bot. If we use bans, it'll return that there is one ban, and if we do unban, we copy the ID, and they've been unbanned. If you found this video helpful, please consider liking the video and subscribing. If you have any questions, feel free to join the Discord on screen or comment down below. Thank you for watching.